Hey, what's up, guys? So I have a very good discussion for you guys today, and that would be something that a lot of players say, which is the quote, "Your deck takes no skill," because, you know, that is very relevant to the meta today when the two dominant decks are very easy to play. And I think that, you know, a lot of players all the time, you know, assume that, you know, these decks take no skill because they simply lose them. Now, I want to say, first off, every deck in Yu-Gi-Oh! Really takes some skill. There are always players that make, you know, mistakes. And let me go ahead and kind of branch out upon, you know, what I mean by, you know, every deck takes skill. And there's always decks that are, you know, more linear than others. So, first off, I want to talk about some of the, you know, higher tier decks. Pretty much, the main decks right now, pretty much, are going to be like Elemental Dragons and the Spellbook decks. Now, those decks, pretty simple to play, but there are always mistakes people make. Even in something like as easy as Dark World is, people make mistakes in Dark Worlds all the time. Let me give you an example of, you know, as easy as Dark World is to play, where, you know, a player that is, you know, less knowledgeable about the game will make a mistake, so you can see kind of like their skill gap. But one example would be, if there's multiple Dark Worlds in Grave, I see a lot of time, you know, very early on in the game, people will use Reborn, and they'll be like, okay, Reborn Graffa. And it's like, why would you Reborn Graffa when there's multiple Dark Worlds in the grave where you can Reborn something like Brow and instantly bounce that card back to your hand, a special summon the Graffa, therefore your Monster Reborn has netted you a plus one, a free Brow. And if you have more Graffas in the grave, hey, you can get your normal summon, bounce it back, and then you'd have two Graffas. So that's just an excellent example of a deck that's pretty easy to play, it's very linear, but you can still see that, you know, they lack the skill or the knowledge about the game. And I would say the correct term we need to use is the deck is linear, not that there's no skill. Even though sometimes, you know, it really becomes unfavored when, you know, a person goes, if they're playing spellbooks, they go first turn Jagan, set Fate, and you're playing E-Dragons, you've essentially lost at that point. Like, it's very hard to deal with a first turn Jagan plus Fate. Like, it's just, like, it's a losing game. It's very difficult to do with that. But, if any of you guys have, you know, experienced, you know, Elemental Dragon Mirror Match, you'll realize that, you know, every deck really takes skill, but, I mean, Elemental Dragon Mirror Match, it comes down to, you know, if once the Blader effect successfully is, you know, off, the other player has one free turn, and you just push as much stuff on the board as they can, just kind of go for game next turn. And, you know, making the Draco Sack or Big Eye at the right time definitely can change the game. And there are other decks that are pretty linear that, you know, still take some skill. Like, for example, Light Sworn, for example. Now that, you know, Evil Swarm Ophion is a card, there are times where you have to Lumina into Lumina to get a Temtempo and detach, and then you can summon the JD and then blow up the field. So, you know, there's always times where, you know, the right player, you know, in the right mindset can, you know, do plays that are, you know, different from the decks, but generally what I want to say is some decks are more linear than others. An excellent example would be something like Plants. This deck was not very linear at all. There were so many options and so many different plays that you can do, and it really showed the, you know, what player had the more, you know, knowledge about the game. They were able to, you know, make plays that, you know, you might not have seen. Whereas something like, you know, Spellbooks or Elemental Dragons or Lightsworn, most of the plays, you see them coming. It's like, oh, does he have four? Okay, he's summoning JD. That's just, it's self-explanatory. If he doesn't have four, then he can't summon JD. It's just, it's really simple. Now, let's take a deck, for example, that a lot of players, you know, have been salty against for a long time. This is Mermels. Mermels, yes, they go Megalo. Sometimes they just go Megalo game. Like, it just, it happens. But there's a lot more options in this deck than some players realize. I mean, I would say if you're salty about a deck, play the deck. Play the deck and understand that, you know, the deck is not, you know, unbeatable. Every deck is beatable in Yu-Gi-Oh! But something like Mermels, like, there's always plays with Sphere, Spike, D.Va, there's always plays where you just might not see coming, like Mistswarm can happen, you know, other cards can happen, they can make, you know, cards that you just normally don't see, like, maybe they're gonna go Army, equip it to a Librarian, like, they can do so many other things than just Megalo. And I think that the correct term we need to use, instead of, you know, getting angry at the player and be like, oh, your deck takes no skill, or being angry because you simply just lost to a deck that might just be better than yours, simply. I mean, you can't tell me Crystal Beasts are going to be better than Elemental Dragons. That's just something that you can't argue. Unless, you know, Crystal Beasts get some, you know, insane support in the future, which I hope they do. I mean, I hope a whole bunch of these other non-meta decks all get support, because I think that it'd be cool to just literally see every deck see some play. You know, it'd just be cool. But, there's other linear decks, like, for example, like, if you open up with Rabbit and you're playing, well, it doesn't really matter what you're playing. If you can summon Rabbit and activate its effect, you're going to summon Rabbit and activate its effect. Like, there's no reason why you wouldn't want to do that. Or something like, example, like Mermels, you might not have the correct cards to discard. Like, you might not have Dragoons. You might not want to go discard two heavy infantry and just summon a Meglo. If you're playing against, you know, something like Evil Swarm, you might just want to hold it. But if you hold on to it, maybe later on it'll hurt you. So you can kind of weigh your options with different decks that have more versatility and more options. Something like even the ZW, the deck, the Utopia deck that I was playing, the deck is very linear. Not to say that the deck doesn't have skill. Like I said, every deck in Yu-Gi-Oh! Takes a certain amount of skill. Now, you can, you know, take your own opinions and decide how much skill the deck takes. But like I said, like with the Dark World example, there are always misplays. Like, I've seen Six Samurai players lose when they have Gateway. It just happens. I feel like this card is just like, it's really one of those game-winning cards. Another example would be like something like Gravekeepers. It's true, it's a pretty linear deck. I mean, it's always first turn Necro Valley set Spy set Recruiter. Like, that always happens. But there are times where, you know, you need to make a Zenmeister, flip the Spy face down. Maybe you got some combos, you got some setups with Book of Moon that you can reabuse Spy with. There's always combos in decks, and this is really what I want to try to tell you guys, is that, you know, just because someone's playing a higher tier deck doesn't mean that they don't have skill. It's just that the decks have, you know, basically one option. Like, well, this deck technically has two options, and occasionally they'll make Crimson Blade, like I said, but generally the decks are very linear. I think that that's more so what you might be frustrated with. But, you know, there's this deck over here, which I still love. I still love the whole Plant Synchro deck. That's definitely my favorite deck of, like, all time. And, you know, there's always, you know, options in this deck. And I think decks that have options are really cool because it really shows your talent or your knowledge about the game where you can make plays that people normally don't see. Now, I was looking for this video. I couldn't find it because I don't remember what I titled it. But a lot of players were in Watcher Chat and they applauded me for this play, which was I was playing some variant of Monarchs. And what I did was I activated a 1-for-1. And, well, okay, this is what actually was on the field. My opponent had game. I don't remember exactly what he had. He had a huge field. And I activated 1-for-1, and I discarded Treeborn Frog, and then I special summoned Battle Fader from my deck, and then I bounced back Battle Fader to my hand with Gen X ally Birdman, and then that way I still had a Battle Fader so he couldn't OTK me. Now that was a play that, you know, some players just simply might not have seen, and then I don't know exactly what happened after that. I don't know what else was in my hand. I just remember that play, and everyone in Watcher Chat was like, oh my gosh, that was super pro. And, you know, I just like decks that have these options where you can see these plays, and you're like, shoot, I didn't know he can do that. Like, there's so many, like, options in the deck, and I think that that's really where, you know, we have more fun with the game when we see, you know, these plays that we don't normally see. Like I said, with Dark World, it's just Grapha, 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 and with something like, let's say Evil Swarm, it's just Ophion, Ophion, Ophion. Occasionally, yeah, there's that, is it Evil Swarm Nightmare? Ouroboros. There's one card that, like, steals cards, you know. I mean, that's pretty self-explanatory, but there's always, you know, options. I mean, Evil Swarm, they could make pretty much any rank 4. They can make Shockmaster as well. There's always options in decks, and what I'm really trying to say with this video is that, you know, every deck in Yu-Gi-Oh! Takes skill to some degree, and, you know, some of the higher tier decks might take less skill, in your opinion, but the thing is, all decks take skill in Yu-Gi-Oh! And that's what I really want to try to say and have you guys take away from this video is that, you know, don't be angry at the game. Just realize the goal of Yu-Gi-Oh! Is to have fun unless you're in a competitive scene and, you know, you're not at a huge tournament. Then, by all means, more than likely, you want to play to win, not for fun. But generally what it comes down to it is, you know, every deck, like I said, takes skill to some degree. But anyways, thanks for watching. Have a great day. Asian Eyes signing out.